My name is Satish Alvatti, Assistant Professor in Mechanical Department. I would like to explain about working of steam power plant. In previous class, we learned Rankine cycle. So today I discuss about how this steam power plant is working. This is the simple steam power plant diagram, and modern thermal power plant diagram is showing here. This is the layout of motor power plant. The major components: boiler having the accessories and mountings, and turbine is coupled with the generator, condenser, cooling tower, feed water pump, and ash handling. This is the layout of modern steam power plant. And modern steam power plant major components are boiler, superheater, reheater, air preheater, economizer, steam turbine, condenser, cooling tower, circulating water pump, boiler feed pump, generator, water treatment section, chimney, and control room. Now we learn how it is working, and a steam power plant having four circuits. One is coal and ash circuit, air and gas circuit, feed water and steam flow circuit, and fourth one is cooling water circuit. Now I will explain the each component working. Boiler is a steam generator which is used for generating the steam, and it is having the accessories and mountings. With the help of accessories, the steam is generating. Examples: economizer, superheater, air preheaters. These are the accessories of the boiler. And mountings are helpful for safety purpose of the generator. Example: water level indicator, pressure gauge, steam separator, and etc. Economizer used for to preheat the water. And what is the use of air preheater? Means to preheat the air. And what is the use of superheater? Means to increase the temperature and eliminate the moisture in the vapor. Condenser used for to convert the vapor into the liquid. Turbine is used for to convert the kinetic energy into the mechanical energy. Cooling tower helpful for circulating the cooling water, and boiler feed pump is always supply the water to the boiler. These are the major components of the steam power plant. Now how it is working means, with the help of pump, we are supplying the water to the boiler at low level to high level. After reaching the water to the boiler, we are supplying the coal. This coal is completely coming from the coal handling plant, and this coal is sent to the boiler furnace with the help of belt drive. And after burning of the coal, it releases the heat energy, and that with the help of heat energy, the water is converted into the vapor. After burning of coal, the ashes fall down to ash pit, and that is sent to the ash storage after processing of ash handling and when steam is generated, the steam is hit the turbine. Before hitting the turbine, the steam is entering into the superheater because of we are eliminating the moisture in the vapor. We are increasing the temperature. We have three conditions of steam, that is wet steam and dry steam and superheated steam. We supplying the dry steam, it having the moisture. Due to cause of moisture, the turbine having the blades and it gets the erosion and corrosion. So we eliminate this problem. We have to remove the moisture from the vapor with the help of superheater. That superheating steam is heating to turbine with the help of steam nozzle, and here turbine shaft and generator shaft is coupled. When turbine shaft is rotated, generator shaft also will be rotated. After expansion process, steam lost the heat energy and that steam is entering into the condenser. In this condenser, we have two types of condensers, jet condenser and surface condenser. In thermal power plant, we are using surface condensers. In surface condenser, it is not direct contact to the vapor. In the condenser having the coil, in that coil it is having cooling water and externally circulated the steam, and heat transfer takes place. The cooling water absorbs the heat from the vapor. That vapor lost the heat energy. That vapor is converted into the liquid. That liquid is name is called as condensate. That condensate is again sent to the boiler with the help of feed water pump. Here we have losses are there, so that remaining water is taken from the river. The river water and condensate both are mixing, and that water is sent to the boiler by using feed water pump. Here at condenser, we having cooling tower. With the help of cooling tower, we eliminate the heat from the vapor. Cooling water is circulated in cooling tower plant. So after burning of heat is sent to the atmosphere through chimney. This is the working of the steam power plant practically.